We all know that it doesn't pay to gamble, but a week ago I heard a paradox that seems to show the opposite, that you can earn money whenever you gamble. Let me show you how it works for a particular game, but afterwards I'll show you how it generalizes to any. The game I heard it in the context of was roulette. Apparently, there's this way to play the game where you just need to guess whether something is either black or red, and both have equal probability. You bet a certain amount of money, and if you're right, they give you the amount you betted. But if you lose, you pay them. This is a game of pure chance. If you play this game a lot, you wouldn't expect to win or lose anything. By the way, if you played this in a real casino, the odds are slightly stacked against you so that they do make money, but that doesn't make a big difference to this paradox, so let's look at the fair game for now. It seems like there's nothing you can do to improve your chance of making money. But let's think about this strategy. What if you said, I'll always bet red? First time, I'll bet two. If I win, I'll stop. Otherwise, I'll play this game again, but this time I'll bet four, and if I lose, I'll bet eight, etc., etc. Then say you won on round three. You win eight, which covers all of your previous losses. The beauty of this is you will win eventually, and whenever that is, you win back everything you lost, and then some. You might say, yeah, but the amounts of money you're betting every time get huge quickly. And that's true. But it's pretty unlikely that you'll even lose that many times in a row. I mean, the probability that you'll lose just 3 rounds is only 1 in 8. The idea behind this strategy is to chase your losses. You know, that thing that people tell you you should never do. If you've lost 3 rounds, then so far you've lost 2 plus 4 plus 8, which equals 14. So you bet two higher than your total loss. That means that if you win this round, you get back everything you've lost plus two more. You can check this for yourself, but this works for whatever round you finish up on. You bet your total losses so far plus two. So whenever you play this game, as long as you go through until you eventually win a round, you always make two. But this seems like a contradiction. You're not supposed to consistently make money playing this game. You're supposed to break even. It gets worse than that, because you can apply this strategy to any betting situation, no matter the odds. You just bet a little bit more than your total losses so far. But wait, before you go and bet on your house, you can see that this is clearly stupid for most betting situations. Most of the time, bets are stacked well against you. Let's say you're playing a game where you have a 1 in 10 chance of winning each bet, which is not at all unrealistic. Then the chance that you'll even lose 12 games in a row is still stupidly high, at about 30%. But at that point, you'll have spent about 8,000 and you're still likely to lose more. So, yeah, don't actually go and do this in real life, please. This strategy doesn't actually work. It's obvious why not when the odds are like this, but when the odds are at 50-50, like in the roulette game, it's hard to see what the problem is. And that's where the paradox is. I'm going to give you a week to see if you can figure it out. It took me a lot of frustrated hours with a friend until we cracked it, but it was good fun to think about, which is why I wanted to tell you guys. It's a really interesting paradox. And if you do figure it out, here are some other variations that you might want to try. What if you decide not to be too greedy and you only bet your total losses plus one each time instead of two? Or what if you get super greedy and you bet your losses plus some growing amount? In these two scenarios, see how quickly the amount of money you bet grows and what you expect your winnings to be. If you need some hints, I have some small ones in the description. Now, good luck. Try it with a friend so you can discuss it. I highly recommend that. Oh, but promise me one thing, that you won't go and gamble this week.